Everybody, is this on? All right. Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you, everybody, for coming out to the city of Pittsburgh. Everybody from the South Side, we appreciate all the support that we've been receiving. It was just a nasty incident. It's hate, and we don't preach hate down here. We don't teach hate. All we do, this is a place for kids to just grow and learn each other so they don't have to deal with hate or hating each other. It's not a place for any violence or any negativity. These men and women here today with me will volunteer their time. They're not paid or anything. Some people work two jobs and still make time to come down here every day. During our season, they're here 6 days a week. And for something to happen to our building, which we worked so hard to get up and running and get painted, it's just heartbreaking for, you know, us to have to still go through this in 2021. You understand? We're a city that preaches that Pittsburgh's against hate, and we all preach that. But, you know, there's still some people out there that don't feel that way. So we're here to let you know that we stand as one. The city's behind us. And we're not going nowhere. Okay, so your kids will still be safe coming to this field. We will definitely protect them like we always have. And we're just going to be Southside strong from here on out. Okay? Next, but if there's any questions or coming up next is Mr. Tim Stevens. But if there's any donations, anybody want to donate to the Southside Bears Youth Sports Athletic Association, they can reach me personally. I'm Kevin Knowlton, I'm the president of the organization, and my email address will be thewayorganization@gmail.com. Oh, ANZTION @gmail.com. Thank you.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, but it wasn't over the weekend. A few days ago, the Black Political Empowerment Project and several of our partners, including Rich Stewart from the NAACP, stood with us when we spoke out against violence against our Asian partners. October 27th, 2019, in our same headquarters, some days later, we stood with our Jewish partners in a press conference to speak about our partnership with our Jewish brothers and sisters. Today, we stand with our African American children. We have the media here today. And in our Coalition Against Violence document Strategies for Change, Building More Peaceful Communities, we have a section on the role of media. So we appreciate you being here. But so often when we think of young black children, and particularly young black men, they are on the news coming out of police cars or going into police cars or going in to be sentenced. Brother Alton and this group are trying to give our black young men an opportunity to be great citizens. And all of us have the opportunity to show love to those young men. And when hate occurs, we must all speak out. So I'm very glad to see the mix of people here today and to stand with one of my newest friends, Reverend Eileen Smith, and my longtime friend, Rich Carrington. It was mentioned, Alton, nice way for the media and all of those watching this news story and whatever's going to be in the paper, send a donation and say Pittsburgh is speaking with our checks and saying we love our young black men who are trying to do the right thing. And we love Alton, who's trying to do the right thing, and all the men who stood with him.
And women.
And women. Thank you very much, because I might get slapped. But seriously, this is the day that we want to see repeated of us coming together to say, no more hate in Pittsburgh. Those signs that we saw coming out of Squirrel Hill, maybe we need to put a couple up on this fence. Hate does not exist in Pittsburgh. Yes, it does, but our goal is to minimize and hopefully eliminate it. That's why we're here, to show support of our young people. And remind me, Alton, I'll write a check before I leave because I have short-term memory loss. But thank you all. This is a moment to move forward. Our next speaker is my friend Richard A. Stewart, Jr., president of the NAACP Pittsburgh branch. We go back many years. Give him a hand. Richard A. Stewart, Jr. My friend Will Anderson, part of BPAP.
Good afternoon. I'm glad to be here. It's a nice day, but it's a messed up day that we have to come out here and talk on hate again. Okay? We have to keep coming out here talking about hate. Now, I believe in my heart of hearts that it was kids that did this. I believe kids did this, young adults, not grown-ups, but then could have been some supervision there. But I want to let them know we're not going anywhere. These folks been here, they paid taxes here, and we're going to stay here. So bring it on. You're going to stay in the shadows in the dark to preach your hate. Bring your butt on out here and let us see who you are. Okay? Let's talk. Are you scared of a conversation? Maybe we might get to you. What do you think? So come on out here. Stop hiding in the shadows, preaching hate. Okay? And I believe if some of the parents knew that these young folks were here, they would do something about it. And with that, I want to thank you for letting me speak. The NAACP stands ready all the time to come and speak and to back our partners. Now, please, don't hate on me if you don't see me in some places, because I get pulled. And I'll try to be there. So if you want me there, call me. I'll try to get there, and I'll speak, and I'll back you. I'm here for the long haul. And I want to let those folks, we're here for the long haul, so we're not going anywhere. Thank you.
We thank everybody for your remarks so far. And now we're going to hear from Richard Carrington, one of the best street violence interrupters that there is. And he's the team leader for South Pittsburgh Peacemakers Outreach, which is a part of the South Pittsburgh Coalition for Peace, which I am director of. And he does a wonderful job, serves as my personal bodyguard from time to time when I might think that I'm going into a dangerous place. Rich is always there along with his team. He's also the executive director of Voices Against Violence. And so right now I turn the mic over to Rich for his 3 minutes.
Thank you.
Hello, Rich.
Thank you, bro.
Take it on.
We came up here together for one simple purpose. Yesterday, we were met with disrespect and hatred of what was done to this building. But nothing was done to the essence of our soul and spirit. So we meet that hatred and disrespect with love and unity. And we start that unity by together, as three separate organizations, committing to working together for the betterment of this community so that we tighten some of the gaps that are there. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Vaughn Madden. I am the vice president of the Southside Bears. You know, I've been a vice president for the last 10 years, and right alongside my brother Kevin Knowlton, he has fought day in and day out to make sure our youth, our parents, and the broader community of the Southside has a place to send their kids, not just with football, but he also runs a summer camp as well. And I just want to speak on, you know, the tremendous attributes of Kevin Knowlton. Like, he is the true essence of what we stand for here on the South Side. You know, we was born and raised with community, always at heart. And one thing that he instills in our young youth, in our parents and our coaches, is to always stick up for one another and do the right thing. And he always taught the kids to do the right thing at every cost, no matter if somebody's looking. And that's what we constantly preach down here. So I'm just always excited and elated to stand next to Kevin. You know, anything that he does for the South Side and for a greater community, because he just not touches kids on the South Side. He touches young men and young women throughout the whole city. His program reaches the South Side and also the West End of Pittsburgh, where he works with kids at Brashear, doing conflict mediation, conflict resolution, mentoring, taking kids on trips. So it's just not just about the South Side, it's about the whole city. And that's one thing that brought me to this organization, is to stand aside of him and to make sure that his mission continues to drive forward. And that's what I encourage everybody to do as they watch this cast on the news, is just continue to support not just the South Side, but his mission. And his mission always stands to do the right thing for the community. So I just want to encourage people to continue to uplift him and all his endeavors, because I can stand here for the last 10 years to say that he's 100% about kids, 100% about the community, and he loves everybody in the city.
Everybody.
He went through so much. He went through so much tragedy in his own personal life, and that's what led him to do this. He lost a brother who is my friend. So it hurts me to stand here to continue to see violence. You know, words come to manifestation. And I just want to put peace back out here in the city, and that we're here to love. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You know, when I saw Kevin going live yesterday on Facebook, and I just happened to be on Facebook. I don't really go on it that often, but here was Kevin, and showed it all. And you have to watch that video if you haven't gone on the Bears Facebook page. It's deplorable. And I had tears in my eyes because I could see tears in his eyes. The hurt. How dare someone. And he was fighting back tears. And he did such a good job, and he called for help. And he was like, I want everybody to post this and everybody's support. And I'm so thankful that people came to his aid. And if you could just see some of the remarks, some of them weren't too nice, so I won't repeat any of those, but a lot of people want to help and want to give money. And I'm just saying that Kevin and the Bears should be overwhelmed with finances and support. And although we as the Birmingham Foundation fund them, they need a lot more money. And this needs to be the first of that kind of movement to help him. I want to at this time acknowledge all of our elected officials and dignitaries here. I don't know who all is here, and a lot of times you can't recognize who's under the mask anyway. Okay, but just raise your hand. There's a lot of, and just shout out your name real quick. I know you're here, so if you want to be incognito, that's okay. Jay Cost is representative.
I'm here as well. There you go. I'm here as well.
You're Jay?
Yes.
See that? You can't see who's under that mask. Who else is here?
Mayor Ed Gainey.
Well, I know the mayor's here, Ned Gainey. Also want to recognize Liz Stowell from Public Safety.
Tony Moreno.
Johnny Marino.
Tony
Marino. See, you know, I'm in a heat stroke right now, too, so excuse me. But all of you, thank you so much for coming out to support, and we have some outreach people, the Pittsburgh Police, Zone 3. We're all so thankful. Very thankful. And these Zone 3 people are my friends, and they've been with me for many, many years and with Rich out here. In the streets, and we're just so thankful for them. Which takes me to now call on Representative Jessica Benham. Could not be here. She is in Harrisburg. She's very distressed. She's a great supporter of ours. And to take her place is her Chief of Staff, Myra Kalida. And then we will be hearing from Representative, and Jessica's from the 36th District. Worked so well with us. We'll then hear from Representative Ed Gainey, our friend also from the 24th District.
Thank you. My name is Maura Kalida. I serve as Jess Benham's Chief of Staff, and she is really sorry she can't be here, but she did send me some remarks last night that I just want to share with you all. Reverend Smith and the entire South Pittsburgh Coalition for Peace, thank you for organizing this peace rally to demonstrate that we stand in solidarity with each other against the racist, white supremacist acts of vandalism. Thank you for your continued work against violence, and yes, these words and symbols are also violent and toward peace in South Pittsburgh. While I wish I could be here with you in person today, I stand with you in spirit from Harrisburg, where I am currently voting on the floor. I am beyond furious at the racist vandalism of the Bear Cave and condemn the white supremacist ideology behind it. I wish I could say that I was surprised by the hateful defacing of a beloved community space, but given that the FBI has labeled Pittsburgh a hotbed of white supremacist organizing, we know that all of us, and particularly my white brothers and sisters, have continued work to do to fighting against the bigoted ideology and for justice. I'm a pastor's daughter and an elder in my church, so my prayers are today and always with our community. For while we often say hate has no home here, we must clearly still work to breathe that reality into being, because our children and all of us deserve to play in a world, to exist in a world free from racism and hate. Myself and my office are here with you for whatever you need, and I look forward to organizing beside you. Thank you.
Queen White's friend deserted me. Well, he was doing a stellar job.
Yes, he was.
All right, Councilman, well, first of all, I want to acknowledge the President of Council, Teresa Kale Smith. She's still here. All right, thank you for being here. And want to recognize Councilman Bruce Krause, who was slated to be. Somebody got a touchdown. Slated to be one of our speakers today. And he has relinquished his time to the Honorable Mayor Peduto. And we are so happy that you came today, Mayor. Take time out of your busy schedule. And I believe this is the first time that you've been with us. And we are so happy to have you here today. So if you would. You know what? I'm so sorry. It's Representative Ed Gainey, but it doesn't matter if you want to come now. Toss a coin.
I'll be brief.
I look like it all. He was ghost on me.
Thank you, Rev. First, I want to recognize not only Representative Gainey, but I saw Tony Moreno is here as well. And thank you. That's unity, and I think that's what the city needs today. Councilman Krause is with us as well. Council President Smith had to leave, Senator Costa had to leave, but I just want everyone to understand there's an entire city behind you right now. there is an entire city behind you. What was done here on Easter Sunday, think about that.
Yeah.
Somebody was not at home with a family. Somebody felt an emptiness inside, and they decided to take it out through words that would be so intimidating and spray painted on to something that was so good. I just want you to know this, Coach. All the money you raise, I want you to use it for programming. I want you to use it for the kids. What we will promise for the city is we'll take care of all this. And not only this, we rise back better. We rise back better, and we improve this entire park, and we work with the community in order to do it. This week, we'll have our public works crews are here. We'll get things ready. Then we'll have a blank slate. We'll rehire that artist, and we'll recommission them to redo this entire building. We'll put together the funds in order to be able to improve this entire area, and we'll send a message to anybody who wants to talk in hate that we will come back stronger. We rise back stronger. We use this event of Easter Sunday as a way of recognizing that, and as we work together in order to be able to rise the entire community. Thank you, Reverend.
I just want to also comment on what the mayor has said about restoring this place. The bathrooms don't even work. What do the kids do, Kevin, when they have to go to the bathroom? Kev, bathrooms don't work. What do the kids do?
We rent Porter John's for the year. We have them out.
Oh, my. Yeah, that's we have to do better than that. Thank you, Mayor. Because I came on today and I said to the work with the bathroom work. And he's like, oh, well, we better make this quick. Okay. And now Representative Ed Gainey from the 24th District, my friend, Mrs. Colling, as our preacher.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Before we begin, can we give the coaches here a round of applause for the great work that they do with our youth. Hate has no place in America. Hate has no place in Pittsburgh. And everybody that's here today, I want you to go tell a friend. I want you to tell a friend of how important it is that we stand up against hate. Because if we don't speak out by hate, not just in our words, but in the actions that we do, then at the end of the day, hate remains silent and is allowed to thrive in American culture. We have to remove hate at every opportunity that we get. Black, white, Latino, Asian, Korean, it don't matter. We are all God's children under the sun. And if we don't stand up, if we don't begin to make hate a priority of elimination, we can never get there. I'm so glad that they went on live yesterday and talked about the hate that happened in this building. Because do you understand the trauma that that puts throughout Pittsburgh? Do you know how our children feel when they see this level of hate in our community? Do you think they don't understand? But when you have powerful coaches that stand in the middle as intercessors and talk to them about what we do as a community to eliminate hate, then we teach them to stand up for justice. And when you see Ed Gainey, Bill Peduto, Tony Moreno, people running for mayor together here today, is a message to how we eliminate hate. When you see guys like Richard Carrington, Tim Smith, Will Anderson, and all the other ones that have been out here fighting this hate for decades. When you see Pittsburgh's finest law enforcement out here, I said it's traumatic and it affects everybody. But let me tell you how we eliminate hate. If our ancestors moved us forward every generation, then understand that as long as we stand unified, we will eliminate hate. Thank you.